your time. You're like a ribbon in the sky. You are a poet in this rhyme. You take me to a higher ground, and then you knock me off my feet. Lately I've been thinking about you, 'cause you've been creeping in my dreams.
The mighty scholars of Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School. Yes, yes, family. Let's all stand in the strong Angalaya and get ready for the pouring of libations.
We pour affirmations to the permission given by our head of school and CEO, Dr. Mama Aisha Imani. Ashe. We pour to the gift of life, love, laughter, and learning. Ashe. And we pour to new beginnings. Ashe. We pour libations to the cradle of civilization known as Africa. Ashe. And we pour libations to the kingdoms that we are named after. Ashe. Nations like the Yoruba Nation, the Congo Nation, the Kush Nation, the Songhai Nation, the Zulu Nation, and the Maasai Nation. Ashe. And we want to pour libations to the kings and queens of the African kingdoms, like King Indubis of the Aksum Nation and Queen Moremi of the Yoruba Ila Ife Kingdom, and founder of the Mali Kingdom, King Sundiata Kida of the Gambia. And we want to pour libations to the freedom fighters of the continent of Africa, freedom fighters like Patrice Lumumba, Steve Biko, and Charlotte Max. Ashe. And we want to pour libations to the Ma'afa, the Middle Passage, the millions of lives that were lost in the transatlantic slave trade. To them we say Ashe. And we pour libations to those who survived, those who made it across the Atlantic. We also pour to the kingdoms of the Americas, North America, Central America, South America, and the Caribbean, like the Mayas, the Aztecs, the Taínos, and the Olmecs. And we pour libations to the freedom fighters of the New World, freedom fighter artists like Marian Anderson and James Baldwin, and freedom fighters like William Still and James Fortin. Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the institutions that teach us about our history and guide us into the future, like the HBCUs, the historically black colleges and universities, HBCUs like the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, Cheney University in Pennsylvania, Florida A&M University, and Spelman College in Georgia. Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the institutions like Imhotep Charter Institute and Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School and the Freedom Schools Movement. Ashe.
Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the educators, those who work in these institutions, learning about our history and educating us about our history, but also learning about our current state of affairs and guiding us into the future, Ashe. And we pour libations to those in our direct bloodline, our ancestors who helped build the foundation of our families. And to them, we say, Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the young scholars like you who are learning today in order to lead us in the future, Ashe. And to the babies and the babies' babies and those who will come and complete our circle, Ashe. And lastly, to the ancestors in hopes that they receive and accept this libation, Ashe. Ashe, Ashe.
The principle of the month is Umoja, and that means unity. The Maadic virtue of the month is harmony. Ashe. I have a recognition. I said I have a recognition. That's right, family. It is now time for recognitions, and we are starting with Yoruba Gardens. Mama Renee would like to recognize the entire Yoruba Gardens and parents for persevering and utilizing Schoology. And for Yoruba Douglas, Mama Dana would like to recognize all of Yoruba Douglas for doing a great job on Pear Deck. For the Congo Nation, Mama Pat would like to recognize all of Congo Cooper for persevering yesterday while navigating through wonders to take their literacy test. She would also like to thank all of the parents for their assistance and continued support with this process. Everyone did a great job, and she is very proud of you. And for Congo Crawley, Sister Lindsay would like to recognize the following scholars who scored proficient in this week's literacy assessment. Ryan Gullidge, Aubrey Bowman, Mulan Campbell P., Drew Noling, Malik Spence, Anari Towns, Neve Bennett, Idris Niangani, Nalan Taylor, Kasim Richard Towns, Jade Wells, and Zenoa Vance. And lastly, Sister Lindsay has just three words, Sister Kamali Johnson. Thank you for everything. For the Kush Nation, Sister Amanda would like to recognize Mackenzie and Cameron for allowing their voices to be heard a little more yesterday. And she would also like to recognize Akai Kegler for using his hand signals well during key detail activity. She would also like to recognize Riley Lynn Benjamin, Nakai Artis Powell, and Aria Gordon for perseverance and hard work. And Mama Dana would like to send a big shout out to Brother Dre for his first math lesson of the school year. You did a great job, great job. She would also like to recognize Tasneen and Azeen for their awesome participation in math class. And to Amari Hankerson for stepping up to participate in literacy class. And for the Songhai Nation, Sister Precious would like to recognize Zafir Cotton for showing Kuji Chakalia from beginning to end. She also wants to recognize Isaiah Thomas for working through obstacles and completing all of his assignments. And for Songhai Roberson, Brother Martique wants to recognize Taylor Hunter and Hassim Oliphant for being focused during math and for their great participation. For Zulu Fortin, Mama Tony and Baba Chris would like to acknowledge scholars who are demonstrating scholarship. These scholars had modeled and modeled back what good readers do by rereading and also by studying notes they take down during class. Shout out to Noah, Layla Monet, Kimara, Kaya, Nathan, Jonathan, Caden, Journey, Kasaya, Terrence, Maesia, and Jayana for being emerging leaders. Let's continue to push each other. And Mama T would like to recognize Zabrian for having a good first day as a new scholar. Welcome to Sankofa. And she would also like to recognize our hardworking warriors, Malaya, Samantha, and Robert. And for participation, she would like to recognize Soraya, Luke, and Malaya. And for doing a great job following directions, Mama T would like to recognize Malaya and Robert and Soraya. And she would also like to shout out Haley for improvements in focusing and completing assignments.
At this time, family, let's all stand once again in a strong Angalaya and get ready for our morning pledge.
We are the scholars of St. Kofa Freedom Academy Charter School.
We are the sons and daughters of greatness. We are the descendants of those who love scholarship, justice, the arts, and the earth.
We take pride in our diversity and find joy in our unity.
We respect our ancestors, our elders, ourselves, each other, and our environment.
We honor the principle of St. Kofa and reclaim our roots to build a brighter tomorrow.
Every day in every way,
we shall learn so that we can teach.
And we shall teach so that we can change the world.
We are St. Kofa Freedom Academy Charter School.
Working to restore excellence in scholarship, culture, and community.
One heart.
One love.
One earth.
One people. I am not the pieces of the
my concrete is of the sweet land of liberty. Who do we see? Land when the harvest dies, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring.
Ashe. That was Marian Anderson, our ancestor of the week, who said, "I forgave the daughters of the American Revolution years ago. You lose a lot of time hating people." Now, let's focus on the last part of that quote. You lose a lot of time hating people. That's important to know because we have to remember how important our energy and our time is. I spoke a lot on that last school year, at the end of last school year, and talking about how important our time and our spaces are and how important our energy is. We have to make sure that no matter how angry we may feel or whatever negative feelings we may feel, we have to make sure that we are using our time productively so that we can grow, so that we could be stronger, to fight against an opposer or to be able to handle situations better. That's what Marian Anderson was talking about. You lose a lot of time hating people. You want to make sure that you are using that energy and that time to make yourself better and to make yourself stronger. Now, as far as the first part of that quote, she forgave the daughters of the American Revolution. Well, the daughters of the American Revolution is an organization of women who descend from people who fought in the Revolutionary War of the United States. And they, up until not too long ago, were a very exclusive group, which means that they only allowed a certain type of people to join. Most obviously, they only allowed people who were descendants of people who fought in the American Revolution. Well, there were a lot of Black people who were descendants of those who fought in the American Revolution. And unfortunately, those descendants were not allowed in this organization called the Daughters of the American Revolution. And Marian Anderson, in 1939, was supposed to sing at Constitution Hall in Washington, D.C. And in 1939, the Daughters of the American Revolution, who they made decisions on who performed at Constitution Hall, and they said Marian Anderson could not perform here. They didn't allow her to. And that led to Marian Anderson not being allowed to do a lot of things in DC because of the decision made by the Daughters of the American Revolution. At that time, the wife of Franklin Delano Roosevelt, FDR, you'll learn more about him as you get older. He was the president of the United States back in 1939. His wife, Eleanor Roosevelt, said, well, that's not right. That's racist. And I'm not going to allow that. She couldn't overturn their decision because clearly they had more power than the First Lady. And by the way, as a side note, Eleanor Roosevelt actually went on to advocate for women's rights and for the rights of Black men to serve in the military during the World War II. So she did a lot of things. And in this case, she said, well, I can't overturn that decision, but I'm going to do something better. And she invited Eleanor Roosevelt in 1939, that's about 81 years ago, invited Marian Anderson to perform at the Lincoln Memorial, which is outside, which is the same space that Dr. Martin Luther King gave his very famous speech about 25 years later. And we'll get more into that as we move forward in the school year. But in 1939, Eleanor Roosevelt invited Marian Anderson to sing at the Lincoln Memorial. On Easter in 1939, it was about April 1939, Marian Anderson sang in front of 75,000 people. In 1939, a Black woman who was known as one of the best opera singers of that time, she was denied permission to sing at Constitution Hall because of her race. But she didn't waste her time hating those people who made that decision. Instead, she continued to be great at what she did. She used her energy to continue to be excellent and great at what she did, that she caught the attention of another person in power, Eleanor Roosevelt. And because she continued to be so great at what she did, this other person in power gave her a platform to do better than what she would have done in the first place. Let's keep that in mind. We could talk about our opinions on forgiving people. We could talk about our opinions on how we feel about the way that we're being treated. But what is very true about the statement that Marian Anderson said, you lose a lot of time hating people. That is very true. And so Marian Anderson didn't lose time. She didn't waste time or her energy on hating the Daughters of the American Revolution. She continued to be great. She continued to use that energy and that time to be great, to where she drew attention of somebody in power in 1939, 81 years ago, which led her to sing in front of a crowd much larger than what she would have gotten at Constitution Hall. 75,000 people. And that is not including the people who heard her on the radio. And so because she used her energy wisely and more productively, here we are 81 years later talking about the great things that Marian Anderson did. Now tell me, have you guys ever heard of the Daughters of the American Revolution? I really didn't, but we know about Marian Anderson, and that is all because she used her energy wisely. She didn't lose time hating anybody. She just loved herself and built herself to become great. Let's think about that. And let's think about how we're going to use our energy to be excellent scholars, to become excellent adults, and to be successful. How are we going to use our time? Let's think about that during our moment of silence. The moment of silence begins now. Ashe. Family, I think it's important for us to always keep in mind how we are using our time, how we are using our energy. And at this time, family, let's use this time and energy to start our day right. Make sure your cameras are on and that you are on mute and that you are showing you facilitating your heads and your shoulders and that you're in Aguilera when you need to be, family. Have yourselves a great and productive day. I will see you throughout the day. Peace. Love you. Bye-bye.